What's the strangest thing you found in your house property after you bought it? We found a stack of acrylic paintings in the basement. All very amateurish. Subjects ranged from creepy little girls to 70s psychedelic nude ladies. Realtor told the owners to pick them up, or they would end up in the trash. They showed up a year later asking for them. Bonus. Junk removal guy loved the 70s nudes. Asked to keep them. Rented the property. Didn't buy. Moved in and found a large sign in the rafters of the garage that had the words meth house. It certainly helped connect the dots with everything else wrong with the place. The previous owner's wife had passed away not long before we purchased the house. About a week after we took possession, the realtor called us and asked if we'd found the owner's wife's wedding ring in the master bedroom closet. We had not. A few years later, we were cleaning on top of the kitchen cabinets and found the ring. Why it was on top of the kitchen cabinets we will never know. We were able to track down the owner and return it. However, edit. Thanks for the gold, kind stranger. My first. A .38 revolver, hidden in a closet. Had a police officer friend run the serial number. Turns out it was stolen in a home burglary in 1973. We found it in 1998. A USB drive belonging to the previous owner. It held 30 photos of his car and one of his wife and baby. My kids found a crawl space up in a bedroom. They found Ken dolls with their hands melted and razors embedded. I did my best to lighten the freakishness and joke that Sid must have lived there. My parents bought a home that used to be a funeral parlor almost 100 years ago. Dad had never questioned why there was a second bulkhead that went nowhere, and when there was a bust pipe they finally had to cut it open. Inside we found a small walled off room that had hundreds of old bottles, odd equipment, chemicals, perfumed salts, stained glass windows from the original building and a few old ledgers plus accounting books. Parents had no use for it and a local antique shop owner town historian happily took it when offered. We had received some cool old copies of photos of how the house originally looked a few years later. We bought our house in September last year. About this time last year our cat started playing with this little wooden thing he found. We had no idea what he was playing with, but when we walked over to see what it was, it turned out to be a little dreidel. We had never seen it before, but that's when our cat let us know he was Jewish. A soldier's pocket Bible. From 1861. Mint condition. Gold leafed. With an inscription from his sister. Whoa. That blew up. Here you go. Pics of the Bible. Inscription and front page. I was off on the year. It was 1863. Edit. I was mistaken on a couple of points. It is not mint condition. But the pages are clean and crisp. As though it had been barely used. It is yellowed with age. And the cover is slightly torn and worn at the edges. I hadn't looked at it in 20 or so years when I wrote the comment. I assumed it was a soldier's Bible as another pass as Fort Galley, VA written on it. It was found resting on the beam on an open wall of a garage in the year 1976. It was given to me as a kid and I put it in a box and kept it with my other real treasures. Final edit. More clarifications as my memory must be failing. The second page mentions Jashank. Assume that means James. Camp Ganley. West Virginia. This article mentions a Camp Ganley in the context of the Civil War. After moving into our new house, we found around $14,000 behind the toilet. Apparently the person who lived in the house before us did not believe in banks. When I was young and we were moving, I didn't feel like cleaning my room, so I stuffed a bunch of knickknacks and some mildly dirty underwear into a hole in the wall before we patched it up. I hope someone finds my treasure one day. A colorized, colors filled in by hand, very large black and white photograph in an ornate gilded frame, found in the attic. The photo showed a young child in a white lacy dress wearing a cowboy hat and boots, standing on the steps of a city building. Think brownstone, with a pony. The house was in the Midwest, and not near a city where such buildings might be found. It was an old photo, and you could not tell if this was a girl or a boy, since boys used to wear dresses. But what you could tell, and could not be denied, was that the child was the ugliest child any of us had ever seen. Scary ugly. I wasn't even envious about the pony. The kid was just so ugly. We hung the photo in a prominent spot. and would make up a story about the person pony photo, taking turns. We left the thing in the attic when we sold the house. Didn't seem right to take it. An uncomfortably obvious meth lab and a secret passageway. Walls had been gutted, leading from a bedroom closet to a linen closet close to the back door. Also, in the same house, an antique piano from the early 1900s. Had it been kept in better condition, we were told it would have been worth at least like $10,000 because that particular model was so rare. I can't find a picture right now, but there was a small cardboard box with several dozen headshots clipped from a very old newspaper in the rafters of my 1915 home. They were all the same photo of a young woman from the neck up, about 2 inches square. Several were pasted into a little leather book on each page. Also, spoon with heroin, probably, residue and Q-tips in an old dresser. Also, what was probably a small meth lab in the basement with mirrors and holes strategically placed to make it easier to see if someone entered the house. Also 15 disgusting ducking mattresses that I had to dispose of. I bought a crack house. Photos. More photos. Before and afters. A cardboard box with a ball gag and handcuffs. I thought it was a box of extra hardware for the closet shelves. This was after they sent a message through the realtor asking if I had found a digital camera. I had not. But I'd be kind of curious, afraid to look at what was on it. Not a house, but a car. Brought home a used 2000 Explorer with a couple thousand miles on it. Saw a piece of paper behind the plastic of the glove compartment. Back where the light bulb is. I carefully pulled it out. It's a white envelope. Inside is roughly $1,000 in various bills. We called the dealership to ask them what to do, but for some reason they either could not contact the seller of the vehicle or the seller of the vehicle refused to be contacted. I wanted to turn it in because $1,000 really duck and helped me out. I would be financially devastated if I lost that much cash. That was a good year, lol. I'm not very tall. I was cleaning out my bedroom while preparing to move out of the house my family had rented for about 3 years. At the top of the closest. Right at the back, where a balled up pair of a stranger's used underwear, that had apparently been there for at least the 3 years we'd lived there. That was gross. Earlier this year I moved into a new apartment and found 4 unopened cans of 7-Up Gold in a gap between my kitchen cabinets in the wall. 7-Up Gold was discontinued in 1988. Edit for those asking. The seals on the cans had obviously failed long ago and all the liquid had evaporated, leaked out. There was about a quarter of a can left in one, but again, the seal was compromised and it was probably so full of bacteria it wouldn't have been even remotely safe to drink. A child-sized WWE belt. Despite purchasing my first home and now being several years worth of salary in debt for the first time, I was most interested in how I could possibly wear such a fine article of clothing to work the next day. Razor blades. The double-edged ones from the old razors. They were in the wall when we opened it up to repair a busted pipe. I noticed a pile of debris in the wall and luckily happened to be wearing gloves. I reached in to grab the debris and throw it away and pulled out a handful of blades. There were several handfuls. I later learned a feature of the mid-century modern bathroom was a blade disposal slot in the back of the medicine cabinet. Super gross and creepy. Also, if you are going to move a bathroom wall in a MCM house, be on the lookout. Change. So much change. Countless pennies, nickels, and dimes with the occasional quarter sprinkled in. All in the ground around the house. Edit. To clarify, so it was all coins from recent years. 60s, 70s, 80s and so on. My family bought the house from a sweet couple who had a lot of foster children coming in and out of their home. We found toys, knives, condoms and so much more in and around the house. In a time we dug around the house, we knew we were going to find something odd. A basement. I seriously bought a house and didn't know it had a basement. In my defense, the entry was through a long narrow laundry room away the back of the house where the sellers kept their dogs. They asked us not to open the door and let the dogs out, and I just never saw the other door. I discovered it when we were moving in. I felt like such a dumb idiot. Oh, I might win this thread. I was taking down some old ceiling tiles in my basement one fine summer day. Things were going surprisingly well, no bugs, mice or asbestos. until I shifted the tile that's directly above the boiler. I saw something rolling off the tile and felt it hit my shoulder. I looked down and in a small pile of dust and paper debris was a wooden dildo. A sizable and clearly used wooden dildo. Now, I was still holding the tile above my head and realized that it was heavier than what the last few had been. Great. I definitely wasn't expecting a fleet enema. Old and yellowed condoms or the mice nest made with shredded porn that was containing all of the previously mentioned items. It was like I was holding a platter of nightmares. But I think the worst part of all of that was when I started to dump it all into the trash. I noticed there was a book under the nest. I won't ever forget the title either. Concentration Camp Bestiality. And that was just the start of the stash he had uncovered. The next tile held far more books and magazines. I called the police once I found photos of minors. They ended up taking away a whole box of books, magazines, film negatives and loose photos. They did leave me with the wooden dildo though. Mercy. The basement still gives me the creeps sometimes. A ticket to the 1934 World Fair in Chicago. Pick of the ticket. Edit. More proof cuz some people don't believe me. The box. The box too. Inside the box. I found a VHS tape from a defunct rental store in the basement. Someone stashed it away in the wood boards of the ceiling and left it there after moving. Part of me felt I was about to get cursed by the ring ghost but popped it into an old VCR anyways. Started it at a halfway point and found some crazy 80s porn. Couldn't stop laughing at the absurdity of it. Edit. Wow. As cliche as it is. This blew up after I went to sleep. I don't post often so this is miles ahead of all my other comments. It's not as strange but I also found, next to the tape, an old schematic map of the house before some of the additions. Interesting but I feel it's more of a usual thing to find in a house. A small frog made out of metal. It has nipples. Edit. Obligatory holy ed. My top comment is about frog nipples. It's bizarre to post an offhand comment, go to sleep, and have it gain traction. It's a small metal paperweight, or something. I really don't have a clue. Maybe someone could solve its mystery? It's probably just bad design but we thought it was hilarious. We found a lot of weird stuff in our house when we moved it. I'll take a pic of frog nips when I get home from work. Shotgun and a weed grinder in the drop tile ceiling of the basement. My house has a two-person jacuzzi tub with mirrors on three walls around it. When I was looking at the house there was a four-post canopy bed with a mirror inside the canopy. Needless to say, the previous owner had his thing. When I was moving in I found in the basement a bar with cuffs on either end hanging from the ceiling and two eye bolts in a board on the floor that would have made this a perfect place to tie someone up spread eagle. I strongly suspect that is what it was used for. I have a room that used to be a bar. Previous owner took the bar itself with him despite it being a built-in. It has a dropped ceiling and the lights are above with clear panels to let the light through. I was moving ceiling tiles to change a bulb and got hit in the face by what I'm guessing was a homemade six swing that was bolted to the rafters above. I've been in this house 15 years and I still occasionally find a secret panel in a wall. It seems anywhere there was an extra bit of space he put a removable panel to make a hidden storage space. And despite all that, the single most surprising thing I found in this house is the light switch in the bathroom that has power going to it but doesn't seem to actually switch anything in the house. What do you go to, you mysterious switch? When will you stop taunting me and give up your secrets? My cousin found an honest-to-gosh hidden room. A bookshelf swung forward and revealed an unfinished place under the stairs. It had a water glass and some Star Wars books from 1996 in it. The strangest thing we ever found was this really long, as in over a foot long, metal screw thing that was being used to hold the windows closed. Still have no idea what it could be for. On the other hand, we buried all our dead pets in the backyard so the next person to move in has a bunch of tiny animal skeletons to discover when they start planting new trees or whatever. Edit. So apparently, there is quite a lot of real estate with homemade pet cemeteries tucked away in the gardens. I found a hidden room. It was a big room that had been finished out, except for the central heat. When I say big, it was easily 15 feet x 30 feet. Here is what was in the room. A boxing speed bag in the corner with a pair of boxing gloves hanging nearby. Over two dozen women's wigs on fake heads. Two mannequins. Both of them were naked, but neither seemed to mind. About 20 garbage bags full of stuff. A pile of women's panties, knickers. At least 30 pair. About 20 hat boxes. Found a box full of random it in our basement of our apartment. Inside there was an Alcoholics Anonymous book filled with handwritten notes that progressively got less and less legible. Phone numbers. Names. Stories. We tried calling a few numbers and no one answered. I think the woman died from her struggles. I grew up in the middle of nowhere, southern Idaho. The farm my folks rented was very odd. There was a ton of old farm equipment from the 40s and 50s, as well as several, about 10, old 50s cars just scattered around the property and hidden in the tree line. The owner had a small shed on the property she asked us to never open. No worries. It sat between the garage and an old mobile home trailer that was never used. We moved away, and shortly after the owner died, new property owners went into the shed, found tons of old World War II and older equipment, guns, bayonets, a Nazi flag, all sorts of it. This shed even had an old school dirt wall basement that had old radios and tons of other crazy stuff. Unfortunately, after the new owners started messing with the shed, the basement, being dirt and all, eventually gave way and a lot of stuff was damaged. They were able to salvage a lot and sold it all, so it worked out. Most I found was a previous tenant's porn stash as a teenager in the old trailer. Best find ever. Edit words. We didn't realize it while touring and doing our walkthrough, but all of the bedroom locks were from the inside. Every bedroom had a medicine cabinet too. Edit locked from the outside, so the person inside couldn't leave. A spider nest hit it with my shoe and out crawled 200 baby spiders going into all directions and crevices of the house. 6 years later and we still killing a spider a day. Hanging on the wall in the unfinished, closed off part of the attic, we found a matted portrait of a man staring angelically off into space as he cradled a deer. Upon closer inspection we realized the man had an arrow through his hand where it lay over the deer, having protected it from injury. We call him Deer Man. Edit. The man in question. We have this side room next to some stairs. While we were moving stuff into the room, we noticed a piece of drywall was coming off the wall, so we took it off. Behind it and under the stair were some way old toys, most likely from the 50s. In the same house about a year later, we paid a company to come put new insulation in the attic. When he was done, he told me we had a portion of our attic sealed off. So we busted through, found a super old sewing table and about 15 boxes of pine cones. Okay, this was when we were selling, not buying, but I guess it qualifies for the question. My grandmother had passed away from ovarian cancer several years ago, and we were just getting around to cleaning out her apartment in northern Serbia to sell it off. There was the all usual Slavic babushka stuff, knitting supplies, weird children's books, communist memorabilia, a piano, bird seed, and the like. It was actually sort of fun getting to experience the history she lived through one last time. But the coolest thing by far was the stash of Austro-Hungarian coins. They were tucked away behind what was previously a seemingly immovable bookshelf. 10 to 15 gleaming gold, 4 ducat coins from 1915, something completely unusual for a former socialist schoolteacher to possess. Thankfully, there was a note with them that explained everything. When Tito's revolutionaries took over Yugoslavia from the Nazis, they tried to reclaim the wealth of their country by going door to door and taking everyone's valuables. In a panic, some families sold off their coins to my great-grandfather, who took the risk to stash them away. Thankfully, he passed inspection and was able to keep the coins. He then went on to live happily ever after as a watchmaker in his village, never spending or even touching the coins again in his life. If either he or my grandmother had been found with them, there would probably be not too good consequences facing them, but they never were. And the ducat survived long past the fall of Yugoslavia to that day when my mother and I were dismantling my grandma's apartment. Here's a picture of one of them. Bill and Ted's excellent adventure for the NES. Just the empty box. Wish I kept it. When my parents bought our house, they found old crates for oranges from 1957 in our basement. They bought the house in 2000. I've still got the crates. Edit. An old friend of mine grew up in the house I now own. I had no idea, but he struggled with severe mental illness from around high school on. His mom left a few boxes behind in the garage and one of them was full of all his old arrest info, letters from his parole officer, and most depressingly, a letter from the judge recommending he be remanded to a psychiatric facility instead of prison. Apparently he lived his adult years in a home for schizophrenics and died a few years ago. The whole thing was just very sad. I once found a machete under the spare tire in a car. When I was 16, my friend's dad bought and sold houses and would pay us to clean them out. In one particular house we found a two-man horse costume, a male blow-up doll, bag of pot, and sock'em boppers. Anyways, we had a great weekend running around our neighborhood in the horse costume with a blow-up doll on top, high as hell. A used tampon in one of our closets. When I lived in a townhouse a few years ago, my roommate and I noticed a message scratched into the side of the refrigerator. Find the X. We searched that place high and low. Never found an X. I really hope it was someone ducking with us, because if I moved out and never found the buried treasure, I'm gonna be pissed. 10 years I've lived in my house, but until recently had never been in the attic. It's a push-up hatch, rather than a pull-down ladder combo, so it wasn't very accessible. There was a weird smell one day, and I was afraid something may have passed away up there, so I pulled out a ladder, lifted the hatch and poked my head up there to check it out. Right next to the hatch in the attic was a huge pile of what looked like stuffing, but turned out to be a gigantic, 6 or 7 foot, stuffed person, like the biggest voodoo doll that ever was, but all white. I tried moving it around a bit to get it out of the way. BC, it was insanely heavy and hard to move. It's torn in places and full of 100 years of dust, stuffing, and whatever the hell else. So yeah, dart, I just left it there, closed the hatch and called it a day. Edit added picture, Imgur. There was a kitchen hidden behind a wall, fully furnished, with a dead mouse under the table that was practically mummified. A ring in a box in one of the floor vents. Floor safe in the garage under an old carpet. Completely empty. When I sell the house in 20 years, I'll put a $100 bill in it and maybe some spent shell casings so the next owners have a cool story. My husband and I rented a house after we got married. The previous tenants were evicted, so there was some cleaning to be done. Since I was pregnant, I was on a cleaning binge anyway. On move-in day was cleaning out the kitchen cabinets to figure out how to set up the kitchen. I found some papers. I read through them and it turns out the previous tenants ran a dog writing ring in the basement. The guy was talking to people online about getting some pit bull pups. It was disgusting. I turned them into the property manager and I don't know what, if anything, he did with the info. I also found Medicaid cards for the kids that lived there. Edit. Dog fighting ring. Attic was full of doll heads. I left them there for the next owner.